This is a Santa Monica Pier. We should go on the Ferris wheel.
That's a view good enough for a postcard.
It's a pretty nice view, huh?
But actually, look.
We're actually in London. Okay.
Pack my bags. Worked a day at work, and in the words of that guy from Austin Powers,
I'm off to London, England.
How's it going? On United, no, Norwegian. Excuse me, I'm flying on Norwegian. Hi, United. And as such, it's a super, super cheap ticket. There's only one major catch, though. In order to get a ticket this cheap, that means I can't get any food on the flight. We're talking about maybe a 10-hour flight, so I came prepared. That should probably hold me over enough. I just saved myself like $200-some. Worth it.
I'm off to London, England.
And doable. But the real bonus of this room, let's see how to do that. There we go. Okay. It's rather nice to have a balcony out here. Okay, so just took a stroll down the world-famous Portobello Road, which you may remember from this.
Portobello Road, street.
The streets where the witches of ages are stowed. And now I'm heading to Kensington Gardens, which of course makes me think of...
Hello, Mrs. Kensington.
So many references in my life, I may have a problem. Only one problem though.
There's no phone. I mean, euros are also accepted here, but.
Can't really use it. It's a phone booth without a phone. Okay. You want to see something really impressive? Look at this. What you're looking at here is the Albert Memorial. That is crazy. Okay, admittedly, I am beyond exhausted. So I'm thinking I'm gonna hike it back up to the Paddington area, catch some dinner, catch a pint at a pub.
Have a nice cold pint and wait for all this to blow over.
You know, one thing about Prince Albert nobody ever talks about? His eyes had a real piercing glow. If anyone gets that immature joke, then you get a cookie. Day two, and I've got a lot of places to see today. Welcome to the Tower of London.
We have word of an attack is imminent. What can you see?
What an ill sight indeed, brother. There's a fleet docked in the Thames. We are under attack.
This is probably the closest I'll ever feel to being in Game of Thrones. There's certainly been a weapons upgrade, hasn't there? I feel like I'm finally in London. Isn't that weird how that works? How, like, seeing certain monuments will actually make you feel like you're at the place that you went to? I don't know if that makes any sense, but it makes sense in my weird head. Definitely feels like London. Yeah, it feels safe. Okay, so the Tower Bridge was just as iconic as I would ever hoped it would be. Next, I'm gonna be headed to St. Paul's Cathedral. So let's head there. I do believe I've made it. Say the one problem with these travel videos that I make is it really doesn't capture the scope and scale of these places that I visit. Basically what I'm saying is go visit yourself. I hope this inspires you to do that. Okay, next stop. Okay, so I'm here to have a little bit of coffee before I continue to the British Museum. And this place has an incredible view. Check this out. Starting to rain. So I'm not entirely sure what happened, but some tourists just came up to get a photo with me. Do I look like somebody? I'm not sure. Anyway, we're here at the British Museum, and fortunately I won't be able to bring this in, obviously, but look at that exterior, it's gorgeous. Photograph inside this area. Obviously, I had to get this. So I'm inside the British Museum, and I got to see something that I've wanted to see ever since I was a little kid, the Rosetta Stone. See just the crowd of people over there. Very popular attraction for good reason. yeah, pretty incredible. But I'm going to go see some of these events, so see you outside.
Ten out of ten. Must do.
All right. I screwed up and I took a wrong turn. I was supposed to go to Buckingham, but instead I found this giant clock. I should, like, get a map or something.
And it's ringing.
Okay, so to recap, we have
Ben, double decker bus,
the London Eye,
all in one take. The city's amazing! Lita found Mr. Bean. Never thought I'd run into him. Following me now. That may very well be the most British thing I've seen all day. I feel like this is a place that Alex and his droogs would have hung out.
Come and get one in the yarbles! If you have any yarbles!
It's kind of creepy. Now, if anybody remembers the film The Bourne Ultimatum, arguably the best thriller action chase ever occurred right here.
I'm gonna walk by you. I want you to move along the far wall to your left. In 4, 3, 2, 1, stand up. That's it.
Tire shoot, right now, tire shoot.
Shit.
You know what? I think there may be enough adventure for one day. Rather early, but I have walked 12 miles today. That's a lot. So I can catch dinner, relax, and go to bed. Wake up super early, catch another adventure. Okay, so I'm here at the Greenwich Observatory with some friends of my mom. This is Jonathan, this is Dawn.
Hi there.
And they were kind enough to take me to the Greenwich Observatory, and there's something extra special about this place that I want to show you guys. So you know on globes how you have latitude and longitude. Well, the 0 degrees, the prime meridian, you know where that is? Literally right over there. So this is where they firmly established the prime meridian that we use for navigation. And if I look, ah, there it is. There we go. I'm standing at 0 degrees longitude. Never thought I'd be able to say that in my life, but there you go. Break here, check out the scenery, and then check out some other places. Look at this place.
the best view, but sound is the only thing that matters, really. These people are real smart. It's a great view. Of course, nothing says London like having a pint at a pub.
Alright, that was a pretty successful day.
I'm gonna go back to the hotel rather early, go aboard the London Eye, and a couple of other leftover things, and then headed off to Spain. Trying to get to the Globe Theater next and then hit the London Eye. Should make for a good finale.
So this church was featured in the Da Vinci Code, and these knight effigies actually remind me a lot of Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade.
Across our ceiling.
Yeah, that was an absolutely awe-inspiring tour. It's too bad today's my last day because I would kill to see a play here. Well, I guess I'm just gonna have to come back and do it then. Boo hoo. Everyone, I'm afraid this is where I must leave you. London is beyond words. I have to come back. 4 days, not nearly enough. There's so much more to do and to see and just walk around and explore. All right, in a couple of hours, I'm gonna catch a plane to Spain. That rhymes. For now, I'll bid you all adieu.